Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Give me a minute.
What for? I have nothing to say to you.
I know. That's why, I'm calling to say goodbye.
To say goodbye?
Yes. I just, let me say that, I'm sorry that things didn't work out for us.
I'd hope they would, but since you won't see me, I'm giving up. I've decided to go away and take a long trip. I just wanted to say goodbye before I left.
Well, I suppose it's kind of you to call rather than leave without a word as you did the first time.
I can't apologize enough for you for that. I just want to say that I've changed a lot from that young man that you knew so long ago. I'm sorry that you haven't had the chance to really get to know me as I am today.
Since you're not interested in knowing, I suppose I have to deal with that as best I can, in my own way. So, well, goodbye.
Are you leaving today?
Very shortly.
I see.
But I do have a few minutes to see you. It would help me if we could make it a clean break with no anger and no bitterness. Iris, may I send my car for you? So we can say goodbye for the last time, face to face.
That the lights wouldn't work. I should have run. I should have left, but I didn't. That was wrong. I tried to find him, Dennis. Well, don't you believe me? I tried to find him, but he just kept hitting me. I'd never been hit before. I didn't know what to do. I tried to run, but I couldn't get away. Dennis, I would have hit him back, but I didn't know how.
Dawn.
Dennis, I'm sorry.
Dawn,
I'm
stop
so sorry.
It. Come on, you're blaming yourself.
I'm sorry.
It's
I did
not
everything
your fault.
Wrong.
Let me hold you. Everything will be okay. It's over now.
Please stop!
What?
Please, just not so close. Not now, just not so close.
Not so close. All right. Of course.
Dennis, don't look so unhappy, but I can't help it.
Look, I understand. I think. But, well, I don't know whether you meant not to hold you so close or not Not to hold you at all. That is what you meant then, isn't it? Dawn, you don't want me to hold you at all?
I will, Dennis. Really, I will. But just not yet. Just not now.
Why?
Because when you put your arms around me, I feel like I'm suffocating. And inside I start struggling to get away like I did in the gallery.
What are you mad? Are you mad at me?
No.
Now, come on, I mean it now. You're not blaming me for this, are you? For not being here when you needed me, for asking you to get the survey from the gallery? Are you?
No.
Well, then I don't understand. Why won't you let me hold you? Comfort you?
Because it doesn't comfort me. It only scares me. When you put your hand on my shoulder, my heart jumps into my mouth. I can't breathe. Don't you know that I'm sorry, too? Please, I just need some time.
All right.
I still love you, Dennis.
I love you too.
Come in.
Gone? Oh, I'm sorry to interrupt. Listen, I'll just wait outside.
Oh, no, Anita. Come in, please. Oh, come on in. Dennis and I would...
Just talking. We were just talking, but... We can talk later. Can't we?
Of course we can.
Well, I'll see you later, Dennis.
Yeah, right.
Anita, thank you for coming. It's so good to see you.
That's what friends are for, right? Hey, Dawn, I am so sorry about what happened.
Anita, I feel like crying. It even hurts to cry.
Just go ahead and cry. Get it all out. Just cry it all out.
Justin?
Allegan.
I just came from seeing his driver.
How is he?
Bart said he's gonna be okay with a little luck.
Bart, what about Kevin?
Bart is Stryker's doctor now. Honey, he just told me about what happened to Dawn, and I'm so sorry.
I should have seen her. Bruised. Swollen. She's a baby. She's a little girl.
Is she gonna be all right?
Physically, she's battered. She'll heal. Emotionally, I'm...
Well, if you ask me, you don't look like you're in such great shape yourself.
I'm fine. I just... I've got a lot on my mind, that's all.
Honey, is there anything I can do for you?
I can't think of anything right now.
Are you sure? Chestnut, I don't want you to take this the wrong way, but I know that your family is hurting for money, and maybe I could help out by paying the hospital bills or something, you know? Honey, after you pay the bills, you might need some help.
Kate's in there seeing about that right now. I don't even know what the damages are.
Okay, when you find out, you let me know if I can help. Jess.
If I need it, I'll tell you.
Okay.
Thanks. Thanks, honey.
Your muscles are so tight. Look, honey, why don't you come home with me and have a drink and relax a little, huh?
Yeah, I think I need that. I feel like a powder keg ready to explode.
This has been real hard on you and your family, hasn't it?
It's been one damn thing right after the next. Seems like Dad was a linchpin. And since we lost him, everything seems to be falling apart faster than I can keep track of it. And the worst thing about it is there's nothing I can do about it. I try to strike back, and there's nothing there.
Doesn't keep you from wanting to get revenge, does it?
Dennis?
Dr. Mahoney, 8-1. Dennis? Come on, sit down.
I can't. I'm just so... You know something? I couldn't understand why you were so bent on revenge. Like that's all you could think about. But now I understand. Seeing Dawn in that hospital bed, hurt like that. Seeing her turn away, pull back from me because I reminded her of the animal who beat her up like that. For no reason. I'd give anything, everything I had, to get the one who did that. And then I'd put my hands around his throat and squeeze.
Amen, brother.
Kind of laid back, ain't much an old country boy like me can't hack. It's early to rise, early in the sack. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, a simple kind of life never did me no harm. Raising me a family and working on the farm. My days are all filled with an easy country charm. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle. When the sun's coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. And life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. When the work's all done and the sun's setting low, pull out the fiddle and I'm rossing up the bow. The kids are asleep, so I'll keep it kind of low. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Leave it to me, babe. I've got a little scheme already worked out. Maggie's having a country western band playing at her dump tonight, right?
You say so?
I say so. And since everybody knows how crazy you are for music, all you have to do is go ask to stay with your Aunt Maggie for a little while. You get my drift?
I think so, but I don't like it.
Come on. Well, everybody's thinking you're listening. What you'll really be doing is you'll be over at the Western Art Gallery, and we'll be making our own music. As a matter of fact, the stuff we'll be making over there will make the music at Maggie's look like last year's bottom 40.
The Western Art Gallery, Dawn's place?
Don't worry. Dawn's not going to be there. Closes at 5. Nobody will be there. As a matter of fact, I just happen to have my own copy of the keys right here, and we'll have the whole place all to ourselves.
Thank God I'm a country boy.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Max, I don't know.
It's what happened to Dawn's last night, isn't it?
I feel so awful.
Yeah. Come here, baby doll. Thought you might. That's why I let you sleep late. How did you sleep?
I kept having these dreams.
As late as Ricky brought you home, I thought for sure you'd be sleeping like a log. Guess I figured wrong.
No, I'm all right. Did Ricky go right to sleep, too?
No, he's too wired out. He's ready to kill whoever it was that did it. Justin and Dennis don't get there first. I tell you, if that ever happened to you, I'd track that creep down and send him back to his maker in a small box.
I know you would. Well, did the police say they know who did it?
No, but don't you worry. Ricky's got plenty of friends at the Houston PD.
I know.
They're bound to catch up with that guy. And when they do, woo!
Did Ricky say they had any suspects or anything?
No, not yet.
Well, what if somebody... Well, I mean... Well, what happens if they don't catch the guy who did it?
Then be free to do it again. Let's just hope the cops get lucky. As far as I know, they haven't got a thing to go on.
Because whoever did this, Justin, is no better than an animal.
Dennis Dawn is my sister. I understand that this isn't going to get it. This is not going to help Dawn at all. After all, she's the one that you should be concentrating on, right?
Yeah. Don't worry, Justin. I'll be here. I'm not going anywhere. Where's Kate anyway? Is she checking Dawn out in the office?
Yeah. Oh, Rena, if I'm going home with you, who's going to take Kate home?
Don't worry about it, Justin. I've got to take Dawn back to the ranch anyway. When she's able to leave, I'll take Kate back.
Thanks, Dennis. Thanks. And then we'll go on.
Justin, wait a minute.
Did you hear a voice?
Hello, Rena. Can't you bury the hatchet for a minute, Justin? Grandma called me to tell me about Dawn, but she was nearly incoherent. Would you mind please telling me what's happened?
Yes, I would mind. Could you please fill Paige in? I don't think I have anything else to say.
Honey, why don't we leave before your mouth gets you in more trouble? Bye, Dennis.
Yeah.
Bye, Paige.
Bye, Rena. What's all that about?
Oh, never mind, Brother Justin. He just believes that if you're not with him in his hatreds, then you're against him in everything else.
Yeah, what hatred is that?
He is for Alex Wheeler. Personally, I just don't share his low opinion of the man. Do you, Dan?
Do I what?
Hate him?
Who?
Alex Wheeler.
No. Which is funny now that I think about it, because I used to hate him. Because I thought he'd hurt Dawn. But now...
Now you see him for the gentleman that he really is.
No. It's just that what happened with Wheeler seems kind of pathetic now, because I thought he'd hurt Dawn, but I didn't know what real hurting was.
Oh, honey. You look like the one that's hurting.
No, I'm not hurting. I'm the one who's hating. And it's all centered on one person. Whoever it was that hurt Dawn.
Better?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Now you take it nice and slow. You know, you look so much better than you did last night at Maggie's. You about scared the pants off of us, girl. Let's see. Well, now, it's not pretty, but it's better.
No. It's horrible. I saw it in the mirror.
Oh, not going to touch it. I know how it is. Remember when Billy Joe hit me? Seems he clipped me in the same spot. It hurts when you blink, right?
Every time. Yeah, this is the part that hurts the most, though.
Yeah. Those are the weirdest scratches I ever did see. Ah, that man must have had some kind of weird-looking hands.
Well, police say that the scratch marks are probably caused by some thick, heavy ring. They also said that, judging from the way he hit me, it was probably on his left hand.
They said that?
Mm-hmm. You know, they even took some pictures of it, some close-ups.
They did? What for?
Well, they're hoping that the scratch marks will lead them to the man they want. It's their only clue.
Oh, Lord, help me.
I mean, they don't even know what the motive would be.
Well, I'm sure the police will work things out. I hope everything goes all right with you, Dawn.
Are you leaving?
Yeah, well, I got to, I gotta get back to Maggie's. There's something real important. There's something I gotta do.
Oh, okay, thank you for coming, Nita.
Listen, I'll tell Dennis to come back in and see you, okay?
Yeah, I guess so. I don't like being alone. Bye.
After you, madam.
Well, thank you. That's one of the things I love most about you.
What's that?
The fact that you are always... often such a gentleman.
Often?
Yes, which means that sometimes you are not. Sometimes you are...
Now, when haven't I been a gentleman?
Oh, 15 minutes ago at the hospital. You were warm and loving to your sister, Dawn, but the minute your sister, Paige, walked in, you were Justin Marshall, Iceman.
You find that strange?
Well, maybe it's not so strange to you, but... Oh, honey, you're so changeable. You know, one minute it's up, the next minute it's down. That's something that's bothered me about you. Did you know that?
Oh?
You make it hard to trust. You're so unpredictable.
Oh, you can trust me, Raina. I'm a man of my word, come hell or high water. Or Alex Wheeler.
Honey, what are you talking about?
I mean that I swore to break Wheeler for driving my father to suicide.
Well, I was talking about how rude you were with Paige.
That's because she doesn't have a shred of loyalty left. She's moved out lock, stock, and barrel and her other assets to the Wheeler camp. I don't have a sister anymore.
Hello, you two. Hi, honey.
Iris?
Hi. I'm sorry, but... I couldn't help overhearing part of your conversation. Justin, may I ask you something?
Depends on what the question is.
Why do you say that Paige has no family loyalty, that she's a camp follower?
You were with us last night at the top of the World Club. You heard her. Couldn't you tell she was on Wheeler's side?
No, I couldn't tell, not from what she said.
Will one of you be kind enough to clue me in? What are you talking about?
The fact that Justin is exaggerating somewhat.
The hell I am. I know what I heard. And I know my own sister. With her, you gotta listen to the music, not just the words.
Hmm. What did you hear in the music, honey?
The wind is blowing to fill Wheeler's sails. And wherever the wind blows, that's where Paige goes.
Well, I listened to her words. And I know what I heard. Paige merely said that she didn't believe Alex was aware that recordings were being made at the club. Well, now, that's her honest opinion. Surely she's entitled to it without being labeled one of Alex's camp followers. What do you think?
Oh, I'm the wrong person to ask, honey.
No, you're the perfect person. I mean, Wheeler's got his teeth sunk in your family, too. Can you honestly say that he's been a loyal, honest friend to your father?
No, but that... doesn't mean that he's all bad, Justin.
No, but it means he betrayed a friendship. He sold Stryker out, didn't he?
I blame Vicky more than I blame Alex for that situation.
I can't believe it. As intelligent as she is, she still can't see through him. But you, Iris, you had a very close look. Surely you don't think he's been honest with you.
No. He could have told me about his relationship with Vicky, but he didn't.
Why'd you believe him when he said he didn't know about Clipper Curtis and his recording devices? Don't you think he benefited from all the information that Clipper Curtis got him up from, that he dredged up? Why didn't he ask him where it came from or why?
I don't know. But what I think doesn't really matter, does it? Saint or sinner, whatever Alex may be, he's certainly not someone I'm concerned about any longer.
Oh, really? That's interesting, yeah? What happened to make you change your mind?
Alex called a little while ago to say goodbye. Seems that everything really is over between us. At last.
Did I hear you right? Is it true that everything is over between you and Wheeler?
That's right.
That's strange. Who would have ever thought that he would give you up so easily?
He said that my turning away from him was more than he could bear. He's going away on a long trip.
And you'll probably never see each other again.
After today, I suppose not. This afternoon, I'll be seeing him one last time.
What for?
He asked me to come see him before he goes. To say goodbye, to make it a clean break.
Is that what he told you? I don't trust him. Neither should you. He's up to something.
Well, of course he is, honey. He's tying up loose ends so he can enjoy his trip and come back refreshed. That way he can start his new life all over again with all those bad memories dead and buried. I mean, you can't envy him that now, can you?
I don't believe it. This is a play of his. He's got something working.
No, I don't think so. He sounded quite sincere. Oh, that's his driver now. I'll get it done. You're not Jack. Are you Mr. Wheeler's driver?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Ricky Decker. I just started working for Mr. Wheeler.
Oh, well, come in, Wheeler, please.
Since when?
Do you two know each other?
Yes, ma'am.
Like brothers, I thought.
Like brothers is right. That's why I took the job, Justin.
Oh, that makes perfect sense.
You better believe it does. Alex asked Terry to have me come up and talk to him about the job after that night you snuck up in the... Well, he wanted someone to stand between the two of you.
Somebody that would protect him.
And you. Hey, what do you want, Jess? You want him to pick a bodyguard who'd shoot the first thing that moves? Alex doesn't want to see you hurt.
And if it came to that, where would you be?
I took the job so it wouldn't come to that. And I'm not on anybody's side. Mr. Wheeler sent me to get you. I'd like to leave now, if that's all right. Are you ready, Mrs. Carrington?
You're making a mistake.
Oh, honey, don't listen to him. You just go right on ahead. Well, go on, honey. If Alex is planning a trip, you don't want to keep him waiting. Now, you just say goodbye to him and get it over with.
I suppose you're right. I'll see you later.
Justin? I love it. I love it. I love it.
You've had this cooking all afternoon, haven't you?
And, honey, it's so fine.
You're going to tell me all about it right now, aren't you, Rena?
Who's here?
Hi, sweetheart. Oh, Dawn, baby. Oh, you poor, poor baby.
Paige, thanks for coming.
Oh, how could I not? You're my only baby sister, sweetheart.
I feel pretty little right now.
Oh, darling. So sorry you got initiated into big city life this way. Guess I should have taken you under my wing or something, huh? Well, you have a few lessons to learn about how things go in the big town. Lesson number one, watch out for yourself and don't trust another living soul.
Oh, Paige.
Except for the people who love you. Like me. You know you can trust me, don't you?
Of course I can.
Dennis, I'm sorry. You've got to know that I don't want to be this way. But it just scares me.
It's all right.
I guess you'll just have to give me time to feel comfortable with anybody. Even you, Dennis. Even you.
Oh, sweetheart, you'll get over it. May take some time, but you'll be fine.
Not too long.
Hope not. I just wish I could stop thinking, stop remembering. If only I hadn't gone back to the gallery.
Now, you know, that is one thing that no one has explained to me yet. Why were you there so late anyway, sweet?
Well, I went back to pick up some papers that Dennis wanted.
Yeah, and I went to New York to see if I could secure a loan so we could buy the gallery, keep it going, in spite of the bankruptcy.
You're kidding. You have got to be kidding. You went all the way to New York for money when your mother is so tight with Alex Wheeler? Honey, he is one of the richest men in Houston.
Paige, we don't want his money.
Oh, come on, you two. It's all green, isn't it? Well, if he offered it, you should take it.
He offered it, but we didn't take it. That's why we went to my grandfather for help.
Oh. That has got to be lesson number two. Never refuse money when it's offered to you, not even from your worst enemy.
Would you have any principles, Paige?
The only principles I'm concerned with earn interest.
Yeah, well, even my mother didn't think we should go to Alex Wheeler for help.
Why?
Because it seems that she's on the outs with him, too. Which reminds me, she probably doesn't know that this has happened to you yet. I'm gonna call her now. Let her know that I'm back in town and why.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I'd like to know where we're going.
To see Mr. Wheeler.
Well, where is he? The World Building is way back in the other direction.
Mr. Wheeler didn't tell me to take you to the World Building, Mrs. Carrington.
What? Well, where are you taking me then?
To see Mr. Wheeler.
Yes, but where is he?
He's on his yacht.
His yacht? He didn't tell me he was calling from the yacht.
Well, yes, ma'am. That's where he is right now. He's planning a trip on it. He did tell you that. Didn't he?
Well, yes, but...
Well, then why not just sit back and relax? Beautiful day for a drive.
Yes. All right. I suppose.
Come on, Rena. What's going on?
Well, they are gone, and
Since you can't do anything about it anyway, I guess I could tell you. You just come right over here, honey, because I'm going to tell you a little bedtime story.
Bedtime?
Mm-hmm.
What are you talking about? Isn't it a little early for that?
Oh, now, come on, honey. Who's telling the story? You or me?
All right, go ahead.
Well, it all started last night when you and Iris went off to your little intimate dinner without me, and you tried to send me home to go to bed like a good little girl.
All right, where'd you go instead, Rena?
Why, Justin Marshall. How wicked of you to think that I'd go anywhere except straight home. Of course, when I did get here, I did find a visitor waiting for me.
Who?
Guess. I'll give you a clue. He owns World Oil Transport.
What was Wheeler doing here?
He was looking for Iris.
Iris was with me.
Well, I knew that, honey, and believe me, I told him neither one of us were happy about you all being together.
Was he very upset?
Well, not so upset that his brain wasn't working at peak efficiency. You know, he is a very clever man. I mean, I can understand how he's gotten where he's gotten to. I mean, he is such a schemer.
Yeah, I knew that before.
Well, honey, I didn't. And when he finally told me about his little plan, well, honey, I was so impressed that I agreed that I would help him. Now, you know me. I don't go around just helping people out of the blue. I have to be really excited about their ideas. And believe me, honey, this was good.
Rena!
Honey, I'll tell you about it in a second. Just sit right there. 1 minute. Hello?
Rena? Hi, this is Dennis. Is my mother available?
Oh, hi, Dennis. No, I'm sorry, darling. Your mother is not available. As a matter of fact, she won't be available for quite some time, maybe even several weeks.
What? Wait a minute. Where in the world did she go?
Well, honey, I don't know exactly where in the world she's going, but she's going somewhere plenty far away.
She? Just her?
Well, she went to visit Alex Wheeler on his yacht, and unless my guess is wrong, they're going to be reconciled real soon, honey, and they're going to go off on some long romantic yacht trip together somewhere around the world.
I don't believe it. Look, Rena, you've got to be wrong about this. I mean, the way my mother was talking, she'd never get back together with Wheeler. She'd never even see him again.
Surprise, honey, she's gonna.
She can't. I mean, she wouldn't.
She can, and she did. Now, Dennis, honey, I know how you feel, but Alex and your mommy really do love each other, no matter what she said to you out of anger. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to give you a little advice. You just start thinking of Alex Wheeler as your new daddy, because that's what your mommy wants.
Oh, that's the worst advice I've heard all day, Rena. Listen to me. I don't care what my mother wants or needs or anything else. I'll never accept Alex Wheeler as my father. Not now, not ever. I really don't believe it.
Hey, calm down. Now I can tell you haven't been listening to the lessons that I've been trying to teach Dawn.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Dennis? Oh, my goodness. You really do need a tutor, don't you, sweet?
This is too much, just too much.
Why'd you do it, Rena? Why? Were you so mad at me for taking her to dinner? Is that why? Just to spite me?
Oh, now wait a minute, Jeff.
You knew? You knew that keeping Iris away from Alex Wheeler was the only chance I had to wreck him, yet you went right behind my back, found a way to get them together. Why? You know how much I wanted to hurt him?
Well, sure I did, honey, but it was hurting Iris. And it was hurting me, too. Come on, now, why don't you forget about all this revenge business against Alex Wheeler? Maybe it's just time to throw it away. Let me help you. You know we need each other. Just like we did 10 years ago.
Rena, you're going to do just fine. You're very good at forgetting.
No, I'm not.
Oh, but you are. You've even forgot what happened 10 years ago when you tried to manage me. You remember? I'll try to bring it to mind, because, darling, that's...
Justin!
It's happening all over again.
You are not going to leave me again, Justin Marshall!
Watch. Thank you.
Mrs. Carrington is here, Mr. Wheeler.
Oh, hello, Iris. Glad you could come. Martini?
Yes, please.
I'm ready now, Oren.
Yes, sir.
Here you go.
Thank you. It was a long, hot drive out here to the yacht club.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was the car's air conditioner broken?
Alex, don't mock me. Why did you make me think you were calling from your office? Why didn't you tell me you were calling from the yacht?
Because I was afraid you might decide not to come, and I was determined to see you.
You are so high-handed. Telling me I had to come. Sending a car to Rena's to whisk me away at the drop of a hat. Your hat. Your whim.
It's no whim. But I'm sorry if it makes you feel uncomfortable.
It's quite an understatement. It was almost like being kidnapped. What is that? Alex, what's happening here?
Hmm? Oh, nothing to be alarmed about. We're putting out to sea.
We're what? Alex! Alex, I came here because you told me you were taking a trip.
I am, and you're going with me.
Well, I am being kidnapped.
Oh, no, you're not. Would you like a stronger martini?
I'm not being kidnapped. You lure me onto this boat under false pretenses, and then you order the boat to get underway. You ply me with martinis, and you tell me I'm not being kidnapped. Well, I'd like to know what you'd call it.
I'd call it being shanghaied.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas. Funniest.